Very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to learn about the role of geoinformatics in modern transportation system. Okay, geoinformatics is very much useful in developing or in managing the transportation related problems, traffic and other things. So today we will see how this geoinformatics approach is useful in transportation management and transportation system. Before starting the topic, first, I would like to start with the basic thing, that is geoinformatics. What is geoinformatics? So as all we know that geoinformatics is a broader term. It is having three components, that is satellite remote sensing, geographical information system, and GPS. These three technologies are combinedly known as geoinformatics. When someone talks about geoinformatics, it means he's talking about remote sensing plus GIS plus GPS. So when we are going to use geoinformatics, so we can have the data sets, we can have different GIS data sets, we can have different satellite images, and also we are having some global positioning system based information, that is you can say the coordinates, GPS data sets or GNSS. The geoinformatics is having three parts: satellite remote sensing, GIS and GPS. So today we are going to see how this technology and how this geoinformatics approach has been deriving the development in the realm of the transportation. As we know that population is increasing day by day because of the rapid urbanization, because of the industrial development. Okay, so if the population is increasing, so definitely the people will be going to use some transportation, some network, some road, railway line. So this technology and the development in the recent technologies like GIS, remote sensing, is very much useful for managing the transport related problems, for developing transport management system. So the main objective of this technological development in the geoinformatics is to meet the demand of faster mobility by different modes. Okay, this time, in recent time, most of the people needs to have faster mobility. They want to have more good transportation facilities. Okay, so GIS can help, remote sensing, GIS can help in such kind of activities. And the development of the transportation management system is also having the objective to build the capacity and expanding the network facilities to accommodate the growing traffic need. Traffic is growing because population is growing. So there may be the problem of traffic congestion, there may be problem of traffic jam. So all these problems can be overcome by implementing or by using geoinformatics. Okay, so this is a basic definition of GIS. As all you know that geographical information system or geographic information system is a computer-based system which comprises with different softwares and hardware that enables any user to capture, store, analyze, visualize and manage the spatially referenced data. Okay, so this is the basic definition of GIS. It is very, all of you are very well known to this term. And so these are some examples of GIS. GIS can be used for crime mapping. Crime mapping is an advanced application of GIS. You can map different crime hotspot, means you can map the areas with a high number of cases. So it can also be used for managing the crime. It can also be used to map the hotspot of the crime area. GIS and hydrology, it can also be used in hydrology. Road networking, that is transportation, which today we are going to see how it is useful in transportation. Traditional knowledge of GIS is very much useful for different kinds of vector data analysis, vector based processing, watershed management, wastewater disposal, and waste management can also be done using GIS. So these are some basic examples of how GIS can be used in different studies are in different applications. So our today's topic is about the transportation, that is road networking. So we will start with only the transportation today. And so what is the need of the advancement in the transportation management system? You know, the roads are everywhere. Roads are a good way to transport from one place to another place. But why there is a need of advancement? What are the needs of the development of new transportation management system? So the basic need of this kind of advancement in transportation management system is to improve the vehicle highway system operation management techniques, optimal use of the existing infrastructure, and also it is used to remove the congestion, traffic jam. In case of traffic problem, in case of traffic congestion, so this kind of advanced technologies can be used to remove the congestion, traffic jam problems, coordination of traffic movements, ease of the driver's frustration, and check the environmental condition and check the stress-related accidents. So these are some factors, these are some issues. That's why we are in the need of some advancement, some development in the transportation management system or transport management system. Okay. GIS can also be used for network analysis or any kind of road networking and transportation. As we know that GIS technology is used for networking. Also, it could be identified through the transport infrastructure life cycle. So this is the infrastructure life cycle, basically in the transportation system. So we can start with the designing of the transportation planning. Then surveying is also part of transportation. Then construction of the roads, construction of different transportation, operation, maintenance, and planning. So it's a infrastructure life cycle for any kind of transportation, any kind of development of the transport infrastructure. Okay, we can start with the designing, then we can go for the surveying, then construction, then operations, then we can work for the maintenance and the planning. So it's a cyclic process, it's a continuous cyclic process of any kind of the development of transport infrastructure. Okay, so first it will start with the designing section. So first we need to design some transportation, we need to design some infrastructure for transportation. So designing section integrates the geographical information system with designing tools. There are several designing tools that can be used to design the networking, that can be used to design the transportation network. And GIS can be integrated with these designing tools like CAD, computer-aided designing. Computer-aided designing is a designing tool, it's a computer-based designing tool that can be integrated with GIS. And by using CAD, we can easily draw or we can easily design some transportation structure, some infrastructure related to the transportation. And it is cost estimation capacities to your infrastructure designing process. So designing process or designing section start with the designing of the road network, designing of the rail network, or designing of the any kind of transportation infrastructure. Now moving to the next slide, surveying section. Okay, after designing, we need to have some ground data sets, we need to have some ground samples. So for that, we are going to conduct some survey. We need to conduct some survey. Surveying section is used to manage and store the GPS data sets using different surveying instruments. Like we can also use total station, we can also use digital level. Okay, when we are going to construct some infrastructure related to the transportation, so we need to have the elevation values, we need to have the water level, we need to have the soil type, we need to have different kinds of other hydrological parameters. Okay, so all these things can be done using surveying. Surveying helps us to manage and store the ground data sets using GPS or total station or any kind of other surveying instruments. That helps you to identify the suitable location for the construction of any road or construction of any transportation facilities. Okay, so surveying can be done after the designing section. It will provide you the basic overview of the study area. Where is the high elevation? Where is the low elevation? Okay, these factors are very important for the construction of any transportation. Then construction management. Okay, after surveying, we can start with the construction. So construction management, like GIS, helps to organize all the relevant project information. Means when you collect the survey data, then you can integrate all the surveying data sets with your other data sets, and like soil data sets, geotechnical studies to planning, the environmental studies, engineering drawings, and project maps, and especially different types of the layer. As we know that GIS helps you to integrate multiple layers. When we are having different thematic layers, like soil layer is another layer, soil layer, then there may be the hydrological layer, then there may be the vegetation layer, there may be different kinds of thematic layers. So the construction management helps you to organize all these layers, all these GIS based themes that can be used for any kind of project information, any kind of construction. Okay, so this is the figure showing the roads. Like these are the major roads, and all these lines are also showing some kind of networking, some kind of system. So we can integrate, we can merge all the themes, all the GIS layers using some GIS system. Operations section includes the traffic management. So in traffic management, geographical information system take a central role in developing effective traffic management strategies. And GIS helps you to view the comprehensive picture of current traffic condition. What are the current traffic condition and how GIS can be helped? GIS can be helpful to view the comprehensive picture of the current traffic condition. Further, those latest information can get to the drivers using the online resources, and it's also allowed to know road clusters, the nearest roads and current travel condition, the situation that is related for the driver. So traffic management includes the real-time information of the road to the driver. Driver will have the real-time information about the traffic condition, the number of vehicles on that road, and what are the condition of the traffic in that area. All these things can be done using traffic management, and GIS helps in traffic management by providing the real-time data sets. It provides you the comprehensive picture of the current traffic condition, and it can helps you to identify the number of vehicles at the time on that road. Okay, so this is the huge powerful tool GIS can be helpful traffic management. So this is, you see here, this is the real-time monitoring of the number of vehicles, number of you can say the traffic condition in an area. So, okay, the GIS can be used to identify, to locate the specific location, because GIS deals with the spatial data sets. So when you integrate this real-time data with the GIS data sets, so it will provide you the real-time data of the traffic condition on any road. So, okay, so this is the real-time monitoring of the traffic condition of different roads in a city. So here you can see they all are connected with each other, and you can have, if you are also connected with that system, so you can have this information on your screen. Then what is the road condition, what is the road condition is there, what is the traffic condition is there, and how number of vehicles in that area, is there traffic jam or not. So this information can be easily provided to you by integrating this real-time data, this real-time information about the traffic that may be integrated with the geographical information system. Okay, so this is the way we can use GIS, we can use geographical information system for managing the traffic, for providing the real-time data about the traffic condition. Okay, so the maintenance and the work order management. So the modern road management agencies have gained productivity and the efficiency by integrating the maintenance and work order management. Maintenance management system allow more efficient scheduling of the maintenance activities. As an example, if we can have manager better than for the maintenance activities in the particular road area, also we can identify how material can be used for maintenance activities and further cost and quantity. This is the maintenance and work order management, and the modern road management system are now using this information provided by the geographical information system that helps to maintain their work, that helps to manage their work. When there is a road construction, so the agency who is involved in the road construction, they will have the real-time data about the road traffic condition on that road. Okay, this is the scenario during the road construction. During the road construction, okay, so this information about the real-time data can be integrated with GIS. So if you are planning to visit on that road, and this information is already uploaded on the website or already uploaded on the web-based services, web-based GIS. So you will get the information that the road is closed ahead or there is a construction is going on that road. So you can divert your route. You will have the option to move on the different roads. Okay. So this information, the maintenance related information, can also be communicated to the user. Okay. But if you are having this transportation management system helps you to identify, to locate the construction sites on that road. So you can avoid to visit that road. That will save your time and your money. And you will not be stuck in the traffic. You will not stuck in the some unnecessary problems. So this is the way we can use GIS for providing you the real-time information about the maintenance work which is going on that road. And if the road is closed, then you will get to know that the road is closed, so you can divert your route and you will not have any problem in that case. Okay, this is the way in which GIS helps you to work as a traffic management system. Planning section includes a transportation planning in which we can identify some better transportation pattern in the particular road network. Okay, and safety analysis is also there. GIS allows you to accurately capture and analyze the traffic accident information as well as to identify the dangerous roads. Okay. If a road is having more number of accidents in the past, so this information will be communicated to you by transportation management system. And if that road is dangerous to visit, or you can see that some of the roads having high number of accidents, so in that case you will have the information about the road that is having highly prone to the accident. If the road is highly prone to the accident, that information can also be communicated to you by having transportation management system. That will be done by the geographical information system, and it will help you to allocate the zone, locate the area with high accident zone area. Okay, so it can also be used for the safety analysis. Transportation safety analysis can also be done by GIS. Okay, and moving to the next slide. Information that is very much useful. You will get to know the information about the hotspot of the accident, any hotspot on the road which is very prone to the accident in that area. Okay, so this information can also be provided you by integrating the real-time data of the road along with the GIS. Okay, this is some of the examples of modern transportation system which is based on GIS. GIS can also be used for smart transportation. It is also be used in aviation industry. GIS is now being used in aviation industry for having the route and navigation of the aeroplanes, different helicopters and different other smart transportation means. Okay, these are some modern transportation systems. Okay, that has been developed with the help of GIS. Advanced public transport system, APTS, advanced traffic management system, ATMS, then advanced traveler information system, ATIS, electronic toll collection and traffic management, ETTM, and commercial vehicle operations, that is CVO. These are some of the advanced modern transportation system which is developed with the help of GIS. Okay, so in India, this kind of modern transportation system was first time developed between the Kotpuli Amir on NH8. Okay, this type of modern transportation system was first time developed for India between the NH8, that is between the Kotpuli and Amir. The major component of such kind of transportation system is traffic management, electronic toll collection, traveler information, and the route guidance. Okay, this is the modern transportation system first time used in the India. So the operating principle for this modern system means your vehicle should be enabled with GPS. Okay, that GPS will provide the real-time data of your vehicle to the GIS system, to the transportation system, and you can also have some camera that is aerial camera or some back camera that will also help you to visualize the location of that area. And all this in GPS enabled vehicle is connected with the GPS satellite that will provide you the real time data of your vehicle when you are moving on that road. Okay, so this is the framework, this is the layout that is used for the modern transportation system. It may have some user interface, then the route generation. Route generation will have the path algorithms, then city bus route algorithm, then there may be the map display. That map will be used to display the shortest path, the closest facility path, and the city bus route. And all this route generation, all the path of the route is stored in the form of database. That database may have the distances between two bus stations, the travel time between two bus stations, the bus number, the timing of the bus at particular bus station, bus stop, and the speed limit. So this is the geo database that can be used for generating the route navigation, or it will help you to provide you the shortest path or closest facility that is near to you, and that may be any ATM, that may be any petrol pump, that may be any restaurant, hotel, anything. Okay, so this is the way this GIS helps you to integrate different data sources, different geo databases to a single platform that will help you to provide you the real-time data about the road, real-time data about the traffic. Okay, this is the Advanced Traffic Management System, ATMS. So the basic and the principal, the major users of such kind of traffic management system are the passengers, car drivers, pedestrians, public transport passengers. Okay, in this Advanced Traffic Management System, ATMS, there is a emergency call boxes are installed at every 2 kilometers. Okay, that will be helpful for the pedestal mounted. It is protected by the safety barriers. This box is used to measure the speed of your vehicle. Then you move in front of this box, it measures your speed. Okay, so that your location will be identified. If you are driving on over speed, so there may be some fine at the next stoppage, at the next red light. Okay, so this is the emergency call box. It provides you the information about the you can say the speed of your vehicle. Okay, variable message sign. These are the digital sign boards which is installed on the roads that will provide you the information about the construction. If there is a construction site, if the road is not available, if there is some kind of problem in the road, so it will provide it you by displaying that information on the digital or electronic signboard. Suppose here it is written here that road work ahead. If you are moving on that road and you have seen this kind of message on the electronic signboard, so you can avoid to visit on that road. You can divert your route to another road. Okay, so these kind of digital signboards, these kind of electronic signboards are being installed at few kilometers on that road. It is a part of Advanced Traffic Management System that provide you the real-time data about the road condition. If there is any kind of construction is there, if there is some accident, if there are some problems, so it will be displayed in that digital signboard. Okay, traffic classification system, it's a kind of statistical information which is related to traffic flow. Okay, this box, this is an electronic system that is having the statistical information about the traffic flow on that road. Okay, if there is high traffic flow on that road, it will provide you the information about the rate of the traffic flow that will be used by inductive loops. It is used for the automatic classification of the vehicles. It measures the speed and the occupancy level. So this is also installed at few kilometers on the road, and it will measure your speed. It will measure your like how many people are sitting in that vehicle. It also measures the occupancy level. That will be helpful for providing the real-time traffic flow. That means it will provide you the information about how many numbers are vehicle to a particular location, how many number of vehicles is traveling on a specific road, on a specific towards the specific destination. So this is the automatic traffic classification system that provides you the statistical information about the traffic flow on a particular road. Okay, meteorological information system. Okay, there are some signboards, there are some meteorological stations are installed that will provide you the wind speed, air temperature, humidity, visibility, the temperature. Okay, this information will be displayed in the digital signboard. This kind of meteorological information system will help you to plan your travel. If you have seen that it is showing the high wind speed or high humidity, visibility or rainfall condition, so you can avoid to visit to that road. Okay, so this kind of meteorological information system provides you the real-time data about the weather condition. When you are moving on a road, so you should have some weather, you should require to have some weather information, whether there is a humidity condition is there, what is the air temperature is there, what is the wind speed is there. All this information can be provided you by the meteorological information system. It is also a part of advanced traffic management system. Okay, electronic toll collection. Okay, electronic toll collection is the kind of electronic, you can fast tag. Right now you have heard the word fast tag is also a kind of electronic toll collection. Means you don't need to stop at that toll collection stoppage. It will be automatically collected. They will automatically collect the toll. There is a sticker which is pasted on your vehicle. They automatically monitor your sticker. They automatically monitor, automatically scan your sticker, and the required amount for that toll is automatically deducted from your account. This is the electronic toll collection system. The principal users are the drivers, carriers, and highways. So services provided by electronic toll collection are the automatic toll exchange. No stopping of the vehicle is there, no cash transaction. Okay, the required amount will be automatically detected from your account. And you don't need to stop at that toll, at that toll stoppage. Okay, this is the advanced, this is also a part of advanced traffic management system. Route guidance provides you the evacuation guidance, instructions, different kinds of facilities, information from the electronic stations, paths. It can be obtained by the travelers for each assessment of their destination. The route guidance provides you the data about the condition of the traffic. It will also provide you the location. If you don't know where to go, if you don't know the location, or if you don't know the exact route, if you are traveling to some place but you don't know how to travel and what route you should choose to reach your destination, so this route guidance provides you the accurate route through which you can reach to your destination without any problem. The route guidance is a kind of, you can say it's a kind of map which is installed in your vehicle. Right now in most of the vehicles you have seen different kinds of maps. Google Maps and other maps are also available that will provide you the route guidance, that will provide you the route that will be helpful to reach your destination. Okay, this is also a kind of traffic management system, advanced traffic management system. Now moving to the next slide. This is the guidance for route planner. So these kind of maps are already installed in different digital map navigators like Google Maps. Some Map My India is also having some maps. Different companies are having their different route maps that will have pre-installed location of that area that will help you to reach your destination if you don't know the exact route, if you don't know the condition of that route or road. So it will provide you the guidance for the route that will be helpful to navigate on that road. traveler information system, it also helps you to provide the information, danger warning, if some kind of accident is there, if there is a high traffic condition, so it will provide you the danger warning. It will show you the danger warning that there is some kind of obstacles, there may be some kind of accidents on that road. So that information will help you to make, to change your decision to travel on that road or not. So this is the advancement in the traveler information that will be helpful for getting any kind of danger warning in case of traffic or in case of high traffic or in case of landslide. Suppose if you are visiting, if you are traveling on a mountainous region, so if there is a landslide, so that information will also be reached to you by this advanced traffic management system. So you can have this kind of information that will help you to save your time, money, as well as your life. Danger warnings such as vision occurred due to fog. If there is a high fog, there is a smoke, okay. If there is a low visibility, okay. So it will show you the message to slow down the speed, okay. That will be displayed on your screen. When the road intersection is closed due to some rainfall or due to some other regions, some landslides, some kind of other problems, so information such as turn right and next intersection on to National Highway will be displayed. So danger warning includes any kind of obstacle because of the bad weather condition, because of the low visibility of the fog and other things. It will also help you to change your decision. That will help you to make the road that will not having some any kind of destruction. Okay. So the conclusion is that in India, like 70 state transport undertaking, which together own and operate 1,13,000 buses and they provide the mobility to 65 million passengers. It has been proved to be the optimal solution to the enigma of building an operating transportation system to meet the expeditiously growing urban travel demand in the developed countries. As per the saying, prevention is better than cure. So it is better to prevent road accidents than providing wide medical technologies to cure it. As the population is increasing day by day, and if the population is increasing, definitely there may be the increased number of vehicles on the road. So in that case, we should have proper traffic management system that will help you to save your time, money, as well as it will also help you to avoid any kind of possible accident in case of high traffic or rush driving. Okay. So these all are the importance of the advanced traffic management system. Thank you very much for today's class, and we will meet again with the next class in the next lecture. Thank you.